الفلاح. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا
ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، يقول الله عز وجل: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: ألهاكم التكاثر حتى زرتم المقابر، كلا سوف تعلمون ثم كلا سوف تعلمون، كلا لو تعلمون علم اليقين لترون الجحيم، ثم لترونها عين اليقين، ثم لتسألن يومئذ عن النعيم. الله سبحانه وتعالى says ألهاكم التكاثر. ألهاكم, it distracts you. And التكاثر is gathering, mutual gathering, meaning that everybody is competing in gathering things to have أكثر, to have more. So تكاثر is that more people are competing against one another to have more. This is our life, that we are always competing against one another and we want more than the other person. And this gathering of worldly things, or this gathering in general, this is not going to stay with us forever. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith narrated by Abdullah ibn al-Shakhir radiyallahu anhu, قال أتيت النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو يقرأ ألهاكم التكاثر. قال يقول ابن آدم مالي مالي وهل لك يا ابن آدم من مالك إلا ما أكلت فأبليت أو تصدقت فأمضيت. هل لك من مالك إلا ما أكلت فأبليت أو لبست فأفنيت أو تصدقت فأمضيت. وكما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم was reading this surah one day and then he said, the human being says, my money, my money. But do you really have from your money, O son of Adam, إلا ما أكلت فأفنيت. Whatever you eat, so it goes out of you. Whatever you eat, it goes out of you. You just use the restroom. أو لبست فأبليت. Or you wear something and it gets old. You have something new, it gets old after a while. أو تصدقت فأمضيت. Or the third is something that you give in صدقة. So in that case, you put it forward for الآخرة. You put it forward for the next life. So these worldly things, food, drink, our homes, our cars, everything gets old. Everything that is new and we are impressed with, eventually it will become old and we will leave it behind when we die. حَتَّى زُرْتُمُ الْمَقَابِرِ. We will continue to be distracted. أَلْهَاكُمْ. We will continue to be distracted. Ibn al-Qayyim, he gave a good point. He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used أَلْهَاكُمْ, that you are distracted, and he didn't say شَغَلَكُمْ, that you are also distracted, but a different word in Arabic. Because شَغَلَكُمْ just means that you are busy with something. So you could be busy with talking on the phone, but you're still working and doing your job. But al-haq means that this money completely distracted you. So it means that you, for example, are completely distracted from your work and you went to attend to something else completely. You are not even doing your job at all. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this gathering distracts us completely. Until we visit the graves, meaning until we enter our graves. Why the word ziyara? Hatta zurtum al-maqabir. Umar ibn Abdul Aziz, he said, I read this surah and I realized that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that if we visit the graves, then we are eventually going to leave those graves, meaning the resurrection. So we die and we enter our graves and then we will leave those graves eventually when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raises us up for the day of judgment. And that's the only thing that will make this love of material things exit our heart, is the fact that we die and we realize the truth. What is the truth at that point? كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ ثُمَّ كَلَّا سَوْفَ تَعْلَمُونَ. No, you will know at that point. You will know at that point what's the reality. And then it's repeated again. ثُمَّ كَلَّا. So this is a tawqid to emphasize that you will have the true knowledge on that day when you are in your graves, of the reality of this life and how much it distracted us from the worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. كَلَّا لَوْ تَعْلَمُونَ عِلْمَ الْيَقِينَ. If only you knew with ilmul yaqeen, with certainty. We know things as Muslims, but we don't know them with certainty. We know that we are supposed to pray, but still some Muslims don't pray. We know many things about our religion, but yet we still do not follow it. Why? Because there's a difference between ilm and ilmul yaqeen. To know something and to know it with certainty. If we know something with certainty, at that point we start to act on it. لَتَرَوُنَّ الْجَحِيمِ. You will see the hellfire. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said in the hadith, مَا مِنْكُمْ أَحَدٌ إِلَّا سَيُكَلِّمُهُ رَبُّ لَيْسَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَهُ تَرْجُمَانِ فَيَنْظُرَ أَيْمَنَ مِنْهُ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ وَيَنْظُرَ أَشْأَمَ مِنْهُ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا مَا قَدَّمْ وَيَنْظُرَ تِلْقَاءَ وَجِهِهِ فَلَا يَرَى إِلَّا النَّارِ فَاتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشِقِّ تَمْرَةٍ. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there is none of you except that he will face Allah and speak to Allah on the day of judgment, and there will be no intermediary between him and Allah. He will speak directly to Allah. And this person will look on his right side and he will only see his deeds. And he will only look on, he will look on his left side and he will only see his actions also. And then he will look in front of him and he will only see the hellfire in front of him. So protect yourself from the hellfire, even if it's only with half a day. Meaning give up charity, even just of half a day. أَقُولُ مَا تَسْمَعُونَ وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ فَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. يقول الله عز وجل: لترون الجحيم ثم لترونها عين اليقين. You will see al-jahim, the hellfire, and you will see it with حق اليقين. حق اليقين is a higher level of certainty. In the surah earlier, it mentioned ilmu al-yaqeen, to know something with certainty. Or ayn al-yaqeen, sorry, is used in this ayah. Ayn al-yaqeen is to see something with certainty. That's a higher level of yaqeen. Not just that you know something and you are certain of it, but that you actually see it and you are certain of it at that point. So of course, knowing something is one thing, but to know it and you're actually looking at it is a whole level of certainty above that, and then higher above that is حق اليقين. ثُمَّ لَتُسْأَلُنَّ يَوْمَئِذٍ عَنِ النَّعِيمِ. And then you will be asked on that day about your blessings. There is a hadith, the time does not allow to mention it, but the summary of the hadith is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left his hadith, this hadith was narrated by Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left his house because of hunger. He's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he didn't have any food to eat. So he left his house just to go and walk and maybe find something. And he saw Abu Bakr and Umar in the same situation. They were so hungry and starving. Eventually, they found one of the Ansar and he hosted them and he slaughtered for them a sheep and he gave them some water and dates. And Rasulullah ﷺ said at the end of the hadith that you came out of your house hungry. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fed you this food. This is from the blessings that you would be asked about. A small dinner of meat and dates and water. The Prophet ﷺ is reminding them that they would be asked about it. So what about our blessings that we have when we live in luxury relative to what they were going through? We will be asked about these blessings in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah to make it easy for us and to make us from those who thank the ni'am and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon us. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya'i minhum wal amwat innaka sami'un qareebun mujibud da'awat ibadallah innallaha ya'muru bil 'adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkari wal baghi ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. If we can try to straighten the lines based on the original lines that are set here so that nobody is praying in the wrong direction. So look at the people over here, they set up in the correct direction. Everybody try to continue that line if you're going into the parking lot.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله